Hey, good afternoon, guys. I'm going to be working on my motorcycle, creating another video today. I'm going to be removing the headlight bucket and the nacelle. The reason I'm doing it is because I need to rebuild my forks. I need to change the fork seals. It's leaking. So I'm about to get started. This is a 2017 Indian Springfield. I haven't ridden it for a few weeks because I was waiting for the seals to arrive. So I'm about to start. I got my trusted assistant here. A little lazy right now. Hopefully he helps me out. Hey, Apollo, look here. Good boy. Okay, so let's get started. So I'm going to remove the headlight bucket first. It's quite easy. You need a 5mm hex. Turn your handlebar to one side. And there'll be two bolts. One here, you can see that. And then another one, I won't be able to get it, but it's right here, another 5mm. So two on this side. Unbolt that. Turn your handlebar to the other side. And then there's two more on the other side, the same top and bottom. So four screws, remove that, yeah. And the headlight bucket won't fall out because there are two more 5mm hex bolts here. So that's holding the bucket. So just remove these four. Don't worry about this falling out. Okay, I'm gonna pause. Okay, so I've removed the four screws for the headlight, 5mm hex. It's easiest to use a T-handle and not try to use a socket wrench and anything because it's easier to access, from here. Now I'm gonna remove these two, 5mm as well. And then once you remove these two, this is gonna fall out. So just be ready to hold it. So I'm gonna place it here. Hopefully this is a good angle. Okay. Okay, now that's done, this should come out, but the headlight will be connected to it. I've got on aftermarket Eagle lights, but the stock headlight should be the same. There should be just a connector here, and you just gotta unplug that. So let me just get that done. There you go, done. Headlight bucket's up. Okay, now it's time to remove the auxiliary lights. They're held together with this bracket with four bolts, two on this side and two on the other side. 6mm, all four of them. There'll be some wiring that's powering up the lights, so I'll disconnect that after I remove this. Just make sure to keep a rag on your fender, because once you remove these bolts, the auxiliary light bracket will fall, and since it's still connected by wire, you kind of want to place it gently on the fender, or hold it, or have another person hold it. Okay, let's remove it. 6mm. Just be sure to collect all the washers and the spacers, right? They'll fall off. So just make sure, pay attention to what order they are in when you take them out. It'll be easier when you put them back in. Okay, I've got the four bolts removed. It's hanging on. It's like a rubber grommet here that's holding the wires in place. So, one on this side, one on that side. So make sure you remove that so the wires come out, and keep them handy because you'll need them in installing, okay? Okay, so to remove the wiring, there are four connectors you need to remove. One for the left side auxiliary right, one for the right side auxiliary right, one for the right side turn signal, and one for the left side turn signal. Luckily, they're all labeled very nicely, so you just gotta hunt in this mess of wires. I've got a lot more because I got a lot more accessories, but just hunt and find the left hand auxiliary right cable. So just a connector, you can plug it out, and then upside down. Front left-hand turn signal, you can see it, right? And then this is a connector. So left-hand side done, and then same with the right-hand side. Where the fuck did it go? It's somewhere hidden here, okay? I disconnected already. Right-hand auxiliary right, again, there it is. And the right-hand turn signal. So once you've disconnected those four cables, the auxiliary right and the turn signal bracket should just come out. Let's try it. There you go, easy. Okay, now it should be easy to remove the nacelle. The front part, sorry. This, and then this. The only thing you need to worry about is the auxiliary right switch. There's a cable running inside. And let me just try to find it for you guys. There you go, auxiliary light switch. So if you want to remove the nacelle completely, make sure to disconnect this connector, and then you can pull both of them out very easily. I don't need to do that, so I'm not going to do it. I just need access to the front forks, so I'll just try to wiggle my way around it. If I need to take it out, I'll take it out, okay?